Hi everyone, it's Becca, and today I'm back on behalf of Wild Orchid Crafts, the Wild Bunch, to share another project with you guys, so I hope you enjoy.
Hey guys! I have been creating some handmade flowers using some Wild Orchid Craft supplies, and I really wanted to share with you guys because I really like how they turned out. So the first kind of flower is this one right here, and I have made two. I've made the pink one and also the blue one. And the blue one is the one that I demonstrate for you guys in the tutorial. Then I have also created this really ruffled kind of looking rose here. And this is the one that I actually demonstrate for you guys. And this is the first one that I had created, and it's like this. I really love this one. And then here is the other one that I have made. So this is the first one I have made. And it is using the organza rose trimmings from Wild Orchid Craft. And then this is the one that I demonstrate for you guys. I just wanted to let you guys know that I will have all of the product codes down below in the description bar so that you can go and check it out. So I hope you guys enjoy, and I would love if you guys would comment on this video and let me know what you think. Thank you so much for watching and enjoy the video.
Okay, so I'm going to start by showing you guys how I have created this particular flower right here. I'm going to be using this organza rosette trim that looks like this. For this flower right here, I have used the pink. And for the one I'm going to be demonstrating, I'm going to be using this turquoise color. And you're going to need to cut out seven of these little flowers. And then you guys can see here, there's a little bit of tulle on the back here. So I just trimmed that off like so. And I'm also going to be using a little circle cut out of cardstock. And this is a 1¼-inch circle. So what you want to do is with your glue gun, you want to just add a little bit of glue right in the center. And now I'm going to glue my flower. I don't like to press this flower down too much because otherwise you end up gluing the actual flower flat to the paper. And then I just go around adding a little bit of glue and placing one of my flowers, for just push it together very lightly so that it covers up the cardstock. And I'm going to do that all the way around. So you should get something that looks like this. And this is what it looks like on the back. The circle is the ideal size for the small organza trim. Now, next thing I want to do is I want to add something to the center. And what I have here is one of the flower-shaped flat-back pearls from Wild Orchid Craft. And this is the 12 mm one. I just add a little bit of glue right to the center flower right here. And then I just put this one on top, like so. And then I like to use some of these sprays here, and this is from Wild Orchid Craft as well, and these are the pearl sprays. And what I like to do is I'll hold on to the second pearl here, and then I'll trim right here. And I can actually go back and use the same stem here, and I'll just trim another two. And last two here. And for this flower, I've only used six. So what I did was I added a little bit of glue behind here in between each flower. So I did that, and then I go in with my pearls, push it into the glue, like so, just like that. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that in between each of these flowers. Okay, now you should have something that looks like this. So it has all these little beads coming out of the flower. And just pull off any stringy bits here from the glue. So I've got another one of the same size circle here, and six segments of this lace. So I'm just going to go ahead and trim that off here. And what I did was I actually trimmed the very end here, this little link that joins it together, just the one here, because when you're gluing this in a circular motion, if you don't do this, it will actually pull the lace together and it won't look right. And then I actually done the same thing on the other side here, but I actually trimmed the two end links here, just like this. You can see here. Make sure you leave some attached together because you want it to still be linked. Okay, and now your lace should look like this. And now what you want to do is, with your circle here, make sure you find the right side of the lace to go facing up. And you want to add just a little bit of glue here. And then you add one of the segments to the glue. And I like to try and curve it a little bit. It's not a big deal if it doesn't. Now for the second one, what I like to do is I add a little bit of glue to the end of the first one, right here, and then a little bit onto the card, because I'm going to overlap this a little bit. Like so. And you can see here how it looks. So it kind of overlaps a little bit. And I'm going to continue to do that all the way around the circle. And just place my flower in the center. Okay, now for the second flower, which is this one right here. I have once again used the organza rose trimmings, which is the small size. And for the first one, I've used, of course, the green. But for the flower I'm going to be demonstrating here, I'm using the gold rosette trim, which looks like this. It's very much a mocha color. So, just like before, I have trimmed out the little flowers here. But instead of using only 7, I am going to be using 13 for this one, because it is a bigger flower. So I'm going to begin the flower in the same way. So I'm going to glue my first 7 rosettes here in the same way as I've done before, and then we will take it from there. And by the way, I forgot to mention that the circle I'm using for this flower is a little bit larger. This one is a 1 inch and 5/8. There is going to be a little bit of cardstock showing, and that is the reason why we need a little bit more of the roses, so we'll get to that. Now, this would have been our flower for the first one, with a smaller circle in the back, of course, but as you can see, I've got spaces left in between here, and that is where I'm going to be gluing my extra roses. So I'm just going to add a little bit of glue in between here, and then push in one of my roses, like that. And I'm gonna do this all the way around. And what I like to do is, if I feel like any of the roses are a little bit uneven, I can just go ahead and trim this a little bit, just so I have a bit of a neater finish. The good thing about these rosette trims is that they're sewn at the back, so they're not just going to come apart. Okay, so now you have something that looks like this. Okay, so once again, I'm going to be trimming off 2 pearls down. And I like to make sure I keep this little plasticky area here, just because that's what I use to glue to my flower. And I need 12 of these. So... and now what I want to do is, you can see here that some of the flowers are a little bit further in, and in between those 2 higher flowers is where I'm going to be gluing my pearl. And actually I'm going to be gluing 2 at a time, so I'm going to be doing that. Okay, and there's your flower. And what I like to do is, for the center of this one, I'm just going to be using a flat back pearl. And this is the cream pearl. And this is in 12 millimeters as well. Now for the outer part here that you can see. I've used some of these flowers here, and this is the mixed color summer blooms in the 4.5 centimeters. And I'm just gonna get some out here. And you only need 3 of these flowers actually, so I'm just gonna put these two aside here. And I'm gonna be using some rusty hinge, and I've got my little inking tool here. And all I'm gonna do is I'm just going to dab it here and then ink the edges like so. And next thing you want to do is you want to cut out these petals individually. So what I like to do is, I don't know if you guys are going to be able to see that on camera, but right in the center of these flowers there's like a little hole, and what I like to do is I just trim from in between to where the hole is in the center, just like that. I just snip it, and that way you get pretty even cuts. So I'm just gonna trim all of these 3 flowers here. Okay, now that I have my petals here, I'm gonna grab another circle of the same size, which is 1 inch and 5/8. I'm going to be adding a little bit of glue, and then I'm going to glue the petal down. And I'm gonna do that all the way around the circle until I cover all of the spaces around. Okay, so I've just glued my last petal here, and I now have something that looks like this. And actually, just a little tip, you could actually make something like this and use as an embellishment. And instead of gluing the petals on the front of the circle, you would then glue it on the back, and then you could add an embellishment to the center. But I actually added it like this because I wanted to have a clean back to my flower. So of course I wanted this facing up, so that when I add my flower here, I still have a clean back. Okay, now for the third flower, which is this one right here. You can see here that I have this ruffled effect going on, and I also have the black lace on the back, which I really like. This is my personal favorite. I really like how this looks, so I'm going to show you guys how I've created this. So I am going to be using a different color seam binding here. For this one I have used camel's hair, and then this one here is actually called Medoc, that's the name there. And it's this burgundy color, which is really, really pretty. So first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab a circle here, and this is a 1 inch and 5/8. Start with my seam binding here. And I'm not gonna cut out a piece just because I don't want to be restricted to a size. And these flowers can be made into whatever size you'd like. So you can make it smaller or you can make it bigger. And the way I like to do it, I just keep on adding. And when I'm happy with the size, I just trim the seam binding. So first thing I want to do is I'm just going to unroll this a little bit here. And I want to crease the seam binding. And the way I do this is I just do this with my fingers, and I just really wrinkle this together, and I keep pulling it and pulling it, and I'm adding more and more to this, and I'm just really pressing it with my fingers. And the cool thing about this is that seam binding creases very, very easily. And now I'm just going to press it with my hands, and I like to roll it with my hands like this, and just rubbing it together like that, and that helps to really crease the seam binding. Okay, and now I have a really wrinkly seam binding here. I'm just going to be adding a little bit of glue to the center of this circle here, just a little bit, and then I'm just going to fold the end of the seam binding together like so. And then I'm just going to push it in. So I have something that looks like this. And I like to add a little bit of glue to the other side here and just glue this down like so. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a little bit of glue to the side, and I'm going to start rolling this around itself. And I don't push this in too much because I want the wrinkles to show. Okay, so you can see here the center is starting to form. And there is no right or wrong about this. You just glue the seam binding as it lands on the paper. You know, just as you roll it. Because this is wrinkly, it's going to be forwards, backwards, you know. There is no right position. Okay, so now I'm just going to push this in very lightly. If you do push it in with your fingers, it might flatten the seam binding because the glue will penetrate and then the seam binding would just glue down to the card very flat, and you don't want that. You want the wrinkly effect here. And I'm just making sure I push this very, very close together here because I want my card stock to be covered. And I'm just going to continue to do that all the way around this flower. Okay, and when you're out of cardstock, like I am here, you can stop there or you can carry on if you like. You can just glue another layer all the way around. But I'm going to call this done, so I'm just going to glue the last little bit here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a little bit of glue on the side and also on the back here. And that is going to allow me to have a better finish to my flowers. So I'm just pushing it together here on the side, and I also pushed it in on the back, and now I can then trim my seam binding, and that's the look that you get. And you could just call it done and use it like this. You could use something else on the back if you like, but I'm going to show you what I have done with mine. So here I have a little embellishment, and this is from Wild Rookie Craft. So the outer circle here is a silver ribbon buckle, and then in the center I have a pearl ribbon buckle, and then right in the center I have a little pearl, and that pearl was from my stash, and I just glued the whole thing together, which you guys can see here. Put one inside the other, and that will make the center of my flower. And now for the lace part, I have used the black Guy Pierre lace, and this is beautiful. I love this lace. And I actually cut out 7 segments for this one. And just as before, I'm going to trim the very end link to the segments here. And this is pretty much the same step as I've done before. So I'm just going to grab my circle, add a little bit of glue here, attach my lace. Okay, and now I have something that looks a bit like this, and I don't know if you guys can tell, but the first and the last bit of lace here, they're a little bit too far apart, and I actually don't like that. So I'm going to show you guys a little tip on how you can fix that if that happens to you, and you can actually be doing that for any of the flowers. Anything that you use a hot glue gun to glue with, you can actually do this. And because this is lace, you just want to be careful not to burn the lace, so you don't want to do this for too long. But I'm going to be using my heat tool here, and I'm just going to apply some heat to the glue underneath the lace so that I can reposition it. So I'm going to show you guys quickly how to do that. Okay, so now the glue has melted and I can reposition these segments here, and I can make sure that the ends are meeting a little bit better. So I'm just going to reposition this, and there you go. That is much better. So that looks much more even, and it doesn't really look like it's joined together or anything like that. Now I'm just going to go ahead and add a little bit of glue in the center here, and I'm going to go ahead and position my flower in the center. And there you go, that is the third flower. So this is the original right here. So anyways, you guys, these are my flowers, and I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. If you have any questions, please comment below and let me know. I'll be happy to help. And as always, I will have all of the product codes down below in the description bar so you guys can go and check it out. Thank you so much for watching. I will catch you guys next time. Bye.